Thou hast mercy upon us all, O Lord, and abhorrest nothing which thou hast made, and winkest at the sins of men because they should amend, and sparest them, for thou art the Lord our God. Be merciful unto me, O God, be merciful unto me, for my soul trusteth in thee. Give sentence with me, O God, and defend my cause against the ungodly people. O deliver me from the deceitful and wicked man, for thou art the God of my strength. O send out thy light and thy truth, that they may lead me and bring me unto thy holy hill, into thy dwelling. Give sentence with me, O God, and defend my cause against the ungodly people. O deliver my soul from the deceitful and wicked man, for thou art the God of my strength. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ said. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart and with all thy soul and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment. And the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. We beseech thee, Almighty God, mercifully to look upon thy people, that by thy great goodness they may be governed and preserved evermore, both in body and soul, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, art one God, world without end. Amen. Let us pray, Almighty and everlasting God, who hatest nothing that thou hast made, and dost forgive the sins of all those who are penitent, create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of thee, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with thee, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, art one God, world without end.
Amen.
The epistle is written in the ninth chapter of the epistle of Blessed Paul the Apostle to the Hebrews, beginning at the 11th verse. Brethren, Christ, being come an high priest of good things to come, by a greater and more perfect tabernacle, not made with hands, that is to say, not of this building, neither by the blood of goats and calves, but by his own blood, he entered in once into the holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us. For if the blood of bulls and of goats and the ashes of an heifer sprinkling the unclean sanctifieth to the purifying of the flesh, how much more shall the blood of Christ, who through the eternal Spirit offered himself without spot to God, purge your conscience from dead works to serve the living God? And for this cause, he is the mediator of the New Testament, that by means of death for the redemption of the transgressions that were under the first testament, they which are called might receive the promise of eternal inheritance in Christ Jesus our Lord. Here endeth the epistle. Deliver me, O Lord, from mine enemies. Teach me to do the thing that pleaseth thee. It is the Lord that delivereth me from my cruel enemies and setteth me up above mine adversaries. Thou shalt rid me from the wicked man. Many a time have they fought against me from my youth up. May Israel now say, yea, many a time have they vexed me from my youth up. But they have not prevailed against me. The plowers plowed upon my back and made long furrows, but the righteous Lord hath hewn the snares of the ungodly in pieces. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The Holy Gospel is written in the 8th chapter of the Gospel according to St. John, beginning at the 46th verse. Glory be to thee, O Lord. At that time Jesus said, "Which of you convinceth me of sin? And if I say the truth, why do ye not believe me? He that is of God heareth God's words. Ye therefore hear them not, because ye are not of God." Then answered the Jews and said unto him, "Say we not well that thou art a Samaritan and hast a devil?" Jesus answered, "I have not a devil, but I honor my Father, and ye do dishonor me. And I seek not mine own glory. There is one that seeketh and judgeth. Verily, verily, I say unto you, if a man keep my saying, he shall never see death." Then said the Jews unto him, "Now we know that thou hast a devil. Abraham is dead, and the prophets, and thou sayest, if a man keep my saying, he shall never taste of death. Art thou greater than our father Abraham, which is dead? And the prophets are dead. Whom makest thou thyself?" Jesus answered, "If I honor myself, my honor is nothing. It is my Father that honoreth me, of whom ye say that he is your God. Yet ye have not known him, but I know him. And if I should say I know him not, I shall be a liar like unto you. But I know him, and keep his saying. Your father Abraham rejoiced to see my day, and he saw it and was glad." Then said the Jews unto him, "Thou art not yet 50 years old, and hast thou seen Abraham?" Jesus said unto them, "Verily, verily, I say unto you, before Abraham was, I am." Then took they up stones to cast at him, but Jesus hid himself and went out of the temple. Praise be to thee, O Christ. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. And I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Today's gospel narrative is the end of a continuing discourse between our Lord and the scribes and the Pharisees and the other Jews who were at the temple that day. The reading brings the action to a powerfully dark end and close, with the people so angry that they picked up stones and wanted to kill Jesus. Two questions that he said brought their anger to the boiling point. Number one, which of you convinceth me of sin? That is to say, which of you convicts me of sin? And number two, if I say the truth, why do you not believe me? The first one, which of you convicts me of sin? Why would they want to do that? Why would they want to convict Jesus of sinning? Well, essentially for two reasons. Number one, he was a threat to them and their physicians. And number two is a universal experience of humanity. Because putting sin on someone makes people feel better about their own sins. You see, it is hard to compare oneself with perfection. So those who heard Jesus needed to carve him down a notch or two, because then their sins would not, so the reasoning goes anyway, look quite so bad in the dimmed light of his presence. There is no doubt that we as human beings are fallen from grace. Man's words and actions sought that truth every single day. In his pride-filled posturings, he wants spiritual advisors, not spiritual directors. He wants suggestions, not commandments from God, because he wants to do it his way, not God's way. He wants to be the king of the hill, the guy who not only makes the rules, but also distributes then the justice to those who fail to live up to his expectations, so that what he does and what he thinks is seen not only as okay, but as the way mankind should live. The scribes and the Pharisees, however, hold no copyright in this matter. They were doing it at that time in the gospel narrative for today, most assuredly. But that is the stain of sin and the stuff of our day also. It is life in this fallen world. And that's why we moan for no ultimate authority in life other than ourselves, so that we can do things the way we want to do them. And the most efficient way of dealing with that, of achieving that goal, or so we are attempted to believe, is to deny God altogether and to replace him with something that does not talk back and tell us what to do. It may be a golden calf, an earth mother father, a giggly goddess, an undefined higher power, a mamby-pamby sweet Jesus, a silly putty savior that we can mold and shape according to our own desires, or simply ethics called situational, which can change depending upon our circumstances and what we want to do today. And as we become more of the world and less simply in the world, as we are called to be in Christ, the list becomes longer and longer, and with each addition we become more disconnected and ostracized from all that is good and holy and eternal. And so the dilemma for we who are alive, the quick, is simple. Sin, the world, and the devil constantly bombard us with delectable choices, which, when and if taken, will lead us out of the presence of God altogether. And we will not have him in our life. And our tendency, because of the fall, is to want to be king of the hill. But can we be? When the only true king is Christ and the only hill worth climbing is Golgotha, Mount Calvary, the place of the skull? The second question. If I say the truth, why do you not believe me? Unwillingness to change. Habitual self-indulgence. Pride, laziness, fear, anger. The seven deadly sins. Sin. Not wanting to set aside that which we value in this temporal existence, friendship, whatever it is, so that we can put on the whole armor of Christ and get on with being what we are not only called to be, but what we promised to God to be when we first became his in baptism. Do you remember the words that we either said ourselves or else we had someone stand up for us and say that we would not be ashamed to confess the faith of Christ crucified, and manfully to fight under his banner against sin, the world, and the devil, and to continue Christ's faithful soldier and servant until the day that we die? And instead of fighting the good fight, what do? We fight with one another. It doesn't make any sense to the angels in heaven or to the faithful here in the world. Man says, have a great time. while you're here. Do what you want to do. And Jesus says, follow me, and you will be spit upon and mocked and jeered. But he also says, and this is the part that we forget oftentimes, in the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. Let's get this suffering stuff straight. Who hurts whom in this fallen world? Who is offering the good life in the long run? Have you been reading the Daily Office lately? If so, you know the story of Joseph. And what he experienced shows us real life. God didn't sell him into slavery. His brothers did. His family did. What's the point? Well, man hurts man. God doesn't. We do it to ourselves. When we offer ourselves to God fully, words and deeds, thoughts and prayers, inside and out, in other words, body and soul, that's what we pray this day, body and soul, we come to know that the pains and the anguishes we experience in this life do not come from the hand of God. They are our own doing. So we can't blame God for the proliferation of sin. Ascribe to him righteousness and strength and greatness. That's what we're called to do. And that's what we do if we know the Lord Jesus. Passion tide has arrived. Think on the sufferings of Christ. And think on your life in Christ. Set aside the temporal. Re-embrace the eternal. But we've only 2 weeks before Easter. So let's walk the way of the cross, not the way of the world. Through suffering, let's walk the way of the cross and straight into the presence of Christ himself. Easter is coming. Easter is coming. Easter is coming. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. I will give thanks unto the Lord with my whole heart. Oh, do well unto thy servant that I may live and keep thy word. Quicken thou me according to thy word, O Lord. Oh God, it is laid the foundation of the world. See you, Holy Father. All things come of thee, O Lord, and of thine own have we given thee. We offer this holy sacrifice to the greater glory of Almighty God in thanksgiving for the passion, death, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Brethren, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
The Lord receive
this sacrifice from thy hands, to the praise and glory of his name, both to our benefit and that of all his holy church. Amen. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord. And grant that all those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may, both by their life and doctrine, set forth thy true and lively word and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who, in this transitory life, are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen.
Ye who do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, devoutly kneeling. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed by thought, word, and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. Have mercy and grant in our heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us. The burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord, Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto our Lord God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God, because by the tree of the cross thou hast wrought the salvation of the race of man, that whence death arose, thence also life might rise again, and that he who by a tree was once the vanquisher might also by a tree be vanquished through Jesus Christ our Lord. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, We laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Let us pray. All glory be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that, his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. For in the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he brake it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, we, thy humble servants, do celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty with these thy holy gifts, which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And we most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us, and of thy almighty goodness vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we, receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. And we earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and made one body with him, that he may dwell in us and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Deliver us, we beseech thee, O Lord, from all sins, evils, past, present, and to come, at the intercession of all thy saints, grant peace favorably in our day, that we, being hoping by the succor of thy mercy, may be both free from sin and safe from all disquietude. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, world without end. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with thy spirit.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
grant us thy peace.
We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table. But thou art the same, Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Amen. Lord, I'm not sure that you guys come out of my roof, but speak the word over my soul should be healed. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him that taketh away the sins of the world.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof, but speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul into everlasting life. Eat and drink this in the remembrance that Christ's blood was shed for thee, and be thankful. This is my body which is given for you. This cup is the New Testament of my blood, saith the Lord. This do ye as oft as ye drink it in remembrance of me. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom by the merits of his most precious death and passion. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end.
Amen.
Amen. Assist us mercifully, O Lord our God, that we, whom thou hast refreshed with thy holy mysteries, may be defended by thy perpetual succor. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Depart in peace.
Thanks be to God.
The peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The beginning of the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory be to thee, O Lord. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor the will of the flesh, nor the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God. Praised, blessed, and adored be our Lord Jesus Christ on his most glorious throne in heaven, in the most holy sacrament of the altar, and in the hearts of his faith-filled people. May the souls of the faithful departed through the mercies of God rest in peace.
And may light perpetually shine upon them.
Amen.